talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say I'm lonely at the top, but just the best. Don't you see me out here shining, shining, better flexing? I hear him talking reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say I'm lonely at the top, but just the best. And even if we die today, don't live forever. Live forever.
Just like I told Coco, my vision is vision. You already know though, so go slow. Back my logo for show, Coco.
Get down on the
yo, listen. Just like I told Coco, my vision is vision. You already know though, so go slow. Back my logo for show, Coco. Get down on
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. We're on to the divisional round now, two steps away from playing on the biggest stage in sports. It's the Patriots going up against the Chiefs.
Larry, as always, it is a frenzied atmosphere inside Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. Coming up, it's divisional round Saturday. We've got an AFC battle on tap between the New England Patriots and the Kansas City Chiefs. The first of four berths in the conference championships on the line here as divisional weekend in the NFL is underway. Feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. No gain on the play there. Second down. 10 yards still left on second down. Brady to throw on second down. And the Chiefs are going to get him. Benny Logan getting in there from his defensive tackle spot to snow him under for a loss of four. Tough spot for the Pats now after the sack as Brady will lead him up third and long. Now Brady. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. It's a gain of seven, and that's going to make it fourth down. On fourth down on now is the lefty Ryan Allen to punt. Tyreek Hill back deep for Kansas City. They'll send this one into the Midwestern air, and it's a good one. A very good return that time. 18 yards, and it's Chiefs football, first and 10. Yardage back at the 38. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. So add that tackle for a loss to the two that he had a week ago.
And you know what he's doing right now?
Smiling?
Yeah, definitely doing that. But he's also patting his guys on the back, his defensive front, because they're keeping him clean, meaning no one's getting to him as a blocker. He's able to run to the football, and the plays he's making, he's spilling them in the offensive backfield.
They run again with Ware. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. It's a loss of two. Now third down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football. An extra corner on the field for New England here on third down.
Yeah, another DB. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And he took the contact as he was throwing it, and the ball drops incomplete.
Trust me, Brandon, I'm not about to try and take your job. I can't do what you do. But that wasn't just three and out. That felt like three and backwards.
That's exactly what it was. You can have my job whenever you want it. The drive that you're looking for, though, probably going forward, bad start to the ball game.
Yeah, not the way to get things going.
And now out come the Patriots. And the last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
Quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. That one good for 13 and a New England first down.
Well, there it is, partner. Brady to Gronk, their first connection of the game.
You think those two often in sync?
I don't think there's any question about it. And look, we know Gronk has a whole lot of fun, but he's deadly serious about his football, as is Tom Brady. Two great competitors, two fantastic players.
That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down. So here we go, first and 10 now. Now Brady. Looking for Gronkowski, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Derek Johnson. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a KC touchdown. That's certainly not something we see often from number 12, Tom Brady, although we did see it in Super Bowl 51.
And that's why it's so memorable, because of what you just said. It doesn't happen very often. And think of the momentum that you gain as a defense, not only picking off Tom Brady, but pick six. Oh, boy, you feel good about yourselves.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Patriots gearing up to go now. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now. And I'm going to take it to the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football.
That one good for 13 at a New England first down. Again, it's Lewis. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
Now White, and he's going to be brought down inside the 45 at the 43. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
That run right there was an offensive line coach's dream, wasn't it? Guys picked up all of their assignments, created a nice gap for the running back to get through. Pick up 7 yards. Yeah, he's probably chortling on the headset right now, saying, we got it going, boys. Let's keep it going.
They'll run with White. Broke through some contact, but unable to reach the 40. They got two of the three they needed there. Leaves them with third and just a yard.
Doesn't matter who you're rooting for in this game. The effort of the man with the football
getting away from one and trying to churn forward and get some yardage. I really liked what he did there.
To throw is Brady. And he will find his man. That's Hogan complete. And he's going to be stopped dead in his tracks around the 37. Brady finding Hogan on third down, and the Patriots able to convert. Now a carry for Wayne. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Well, that play was doomed right from the start.
He just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
On second down, here's Brady. And he's taken down, a Chiefs sack. It's the former Patriot Pro Bowler, Vince Wilford. With a great push up front, he picks up the sack and a loss of eight. Tough spot for the Pats now after the sack as Brady will lead him up third and long. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Throwing left side, he's got Gronk complete. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. They get 12 yards back, but it still leads to a fourth and long. They are, however, facing a fourth, and the first play will be a field goal try. The wind is at his back here in the second quarter. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
And now here comes Kansas City. And a three and out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out with a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive.
Sometimes it actually serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Short of the 45 at the 44. That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards.
I love when a play results in a game that I can actually kind of fall back on one of my favorite adages, and that is anytime there's a run over 10 yards, it means that the offensive line did its job, but you know who else did? The wide receiver. Because the first 7 yards kind of belong to the offensive line and the running back. Anything after that means the wide receivers did a great job of blocking downfield, being willing to mix it up, and give them some more space to gain additional yardage.
Green 39! Green 39!
Now they'll throw with Mahomes. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he is knocked down and then landed on pretty awkwardly. That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards. They'll run it now. This is Charkhandrick West. And he'll bring this one inside the 35. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
There we go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get a little over two, maybe a full three down to the 32-yard line.
I once had a defensive player in the NFL tell me, if I beat and dominate the guy across from me, I'm helping my team. Well, winning one-on-one battles is always a part of the game. But when you have good team defense, as we just saw there, one broken tackle, but he didn't get away because the rest of the guys arrived to put him on the ground.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive going. Clock running, under four to play now as they come up on first and ten.
Here we go now.
Now West, and he is leveled. Knocked down hard, right at the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. This one down to the 30. 2 yards gets them back to where they started, but now third and 10.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football, but these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Third down, that's West, and he'll fall forward to the 29-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down. Here's Cairo Santos now for the Chiefs' field goal. From the left hash, this from 46. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. Going to give this time to the tailback. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up third and five. New England on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be third and five. Here's White. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
I definitely like the play call. You don't expect it on third and five, third and six, do you? You expect a pass play. Had a little courage there to call the run, and boy, they were successful.
On first and ten, here's Brady. Fights him off. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he'll be knocked down sideways. Give him 7 on the play, and that'll make it a second down.
Now, that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
A handoff as they run the counter play. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a third and about 3 to go. New England on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. Brady going to try and throw on third down. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this 3rd down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. And now here comes Kansas City. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
And not great starting field position here for the offense. Here's a carry for the fullback. That's Anthony Sherman. And able to get it across the 10 to the 15. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. As it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Now a play fake here on first down. And going deep for Hill. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining.
Well, partner, I guess that answers the question about whether they're going to sit on it or not.
It does. Now we'll see if they try that again.
Yeah, I think what we find on plays like that, when you take that shot, if you're unsuccessful, then you go way more conservative to finish the half, you know? I think that's the way they'll go.
Ware takes the give from Mahomes. And not even back to the line of scrimmage this time as they're on him quickly once more. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And that's going to lead to a 3rd and 12. So hold that thought, Mr. Ridley. We've got a trip to the title game on the line. Folks are eager to get right back to the action. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number 3. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
2nd down following the run. They'll run it now out of the gun. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Just a couple on the ground there. That's going to bring up 3rd and about 6.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. The Chiefs on 3rd down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6.
All right, now, look at 56. Let's go there.
From the gun, it's Mahomes. And incomplete on the deep ball. Well, they haven't had a whole lot of success in the passing game here. Now, in the second half, he's thinking, I guess maybe just take a shot deep.
I think you're right. Almost looking for a bailout, isn't he? Can my receiver go up and make a big play for me? Can I create a penalty downfield, maybe pick up an interference call and get that yardage downfield? Anything trying to get going again, but you're right. He definitely took a shot.
Great coverage there. Holds him to a 2-yard return following a 50-yard punt. And the Patriots take over. They'll start things on 1st down with Deion Lewis. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That one good for 33 and a first.
This is a little bit like baseball here. Strong up the middle.
Both sides want to be that. In this case, the offense ended up winning the ultimate battle.
And those big runs between the tackles, that's a little deflating for a defense, isn't it?
It really is, because that's where your strength's supposed to be. You're supposed to be in a spot where they can't make that yardage there. You're supposed to send them outside. Not in this case.
And he's brought down. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12.
Well, it certainly appears that the big guys up front have taken charge of the line of scrimmage. Two really nice plays back to back. But on the defensive side of the ball, there shouldn't be any despair. Okay, they've got us a couple of times here. Hang in there, keep your composure, and try and figure it out for the next play.
And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. Now they'll throw with Brady. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. The wideout Chris Hogan, the intended receiver. And it's second down. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Call it a gain of 4, and it'll leave them with a third down and 6 to go. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. Throwing is Brady on third down. And shedding through the tackle. His throw caught at about the 5. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll run for it with Deion Lewis. And he's over the line and into the end zone for a Patriots score. Deion Lewis, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. And he'll put it through, and that evens us up at 10 apiece. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. So now here are the Chiefs as their offense makes their way back out onto the field. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They got to just take a deep breath, relax, try to figure out what is working, and call more of that.
To the right side, it's Kelsey. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. A gain of 6 there on first. Second down now after the pass completion. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. They'll run it now out of the gun. And an alley to run. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards.
For so many years, I was convinced it was a myth, you know, because you always hear about the smaller running back, like, it's lost, you can't find him, and sometimes that's part of his genius. But it's true. You get behind big offensive linemen, the defensive line guys trying to find him, trying to peek around people to see him, and he gets lost, but this guy gets lost in a good way for his offense, picking up big yardage.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48. Another 2-yard gain there, but they'll need to do better this time. It's 3rd and 6. Mahomes now to throw. into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Dante Hightower. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. That's now his second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Easy.
Now Brady throwing on second down. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Hogan. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out, to the sideline, and make a catch.
On first down, Brady. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski. Complete. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10.
Well, the stats that matter on this play don't help a team very much, unless, of course, you're playing defense.
If you're getting points per reception, you got a reception, but yeah, no yardage. Great job by the defense, though. They read through that one.
They read through it, gave up no yardage, and people got credit for tackles. Pretty good deal.
And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats, but really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step. We're back now in KC. New England on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 10. They go play action for White. Now it's Brady. And Allen's got it. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Brady gives this one to Lewis, and he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
Now Lewis, and he's going to get this one down to the 30. 1 yard officially on the pickup, and it'll leave him with a third and 11.
The best defensive lineman, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
New England on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This is third and 11. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. He's able to chew up 8 yards on the carry there, but still, fourth down upcoming. Have to kick this field goal, don't you?
No question about it. Look at the clock. Look at the situation. Kick the field goal.
And the 11-year veteran bangs it through, and they will take the lead at 13-10. So the drive here ends with a field goal, and that does give them the lead, but this one is still a long ways from over.
And you love to be able to look up at the scoreboard and see that you're out in front, but then you take one look across the field and see that offense is raring to come back out, and you think, I don't know that field goals are going to be enough to get us home.
And now here comes Kansas City. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. second down, here's Mahomes. Looking downfield for Kelce. And got his man complete. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. And that one results in 35 yards. Shift together here from the D-line. They go play action here on first down. Oh, no, he lost the football. Oh, no, he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Patriots. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two. See if they stay on the ground for second down. They run. This is Lewis. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Deion Lewis, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the forced fumble defensively leads to 6 points for the Patriots. And they're able to up the lead by one more. Gostkowski now out to kick it away. This is taken at the 3. And now here comes Kansas City. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be...
That's caught at the 25. And all the way down to the 24-yard line. It's a big play there for the Chiefs. 54 yards. On first down, Mahomes. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Coney Ealy from that outside linebacker spot. He's able to get in there for a loss of 9. They'll run it now out of the gun. Works his way inside the 30 on a pickup of 4.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And his kick is absolutely perfect. And that will tighten this one up a bit. Now a one-score game at 20-13. All right, so you needed 2 scores to get back in the game. The field goal then maybe not exactly what they wanted, but it's a necessary first step.
Still plenty of time remaining, but you could really use a stop defensively.
Now a hit and a loose football. And it's picked up by the Chiefs. And they take over already 5 yards deep into the red zone at the 15-yard line.
When you kick off and you go downfield and get the ball back, that's what I call a great opportunity.
In a one-score game, I always circle, and you know this, but in my play-by-play sheet, I circle big plays. It could be turning points. This could be a turning point.
Did you put a second circle around this? Or this
I put a star.
Big.
I put a star. Oh, no, he lost the football. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue line it.
From the 2-yard line now, it's first and goal. And they'll get him down just shy of the goal line at about the 1. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now.
Well, big man with ball met bigger man on the other side of the line. A really nice play for the defense.
They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. They come out here in the eye. On the run, it's Ware. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. He lost 2 there, and it's 3rd down. And this offense on 3rd down today, they've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. They're looking at a 3rd and goal here. Get the yard he needed. He goes the wrong direction. And a loss of 3 to bring up 4th. Game on the line. Season on the line. They're going for it here on 4th down. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. They had the play call on 4th and goal, but it's dropped in the end zone. And as a result, their playoff run may end right here. And tough starting field position here. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. It'll be a Patriot first down on a pickup of 16. And remember here, no timeouts.
And this may be a case of too little, too late.
Trying to say I'm only enemy. Got a cold when my dogs can't get in between. I can give them life, no more energy. Amen, amen. Spent about 60 on the time, I can't even lie. No way in, no way out, doubt, do or die. So I roll when I roll, must be. Amen, amen.
I can't ride Benz, I don't do peace. I beast, I gotta eat. Saber-tooth, tiger, diamond, tooth, teeth. Rockin' right now, won't you come peek? I was outside. The way that shake, leave your mouth wide. You need to say grace for you say thanks.
Amen, amen. What's left in my life, don't know what's in store. I've been dealing with these blessings that I can't ignore.